Okay, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Cortina d'Ampezzo. Welcome to our fourth live chat this season. We are actually broadcasting live from Cortina d'Ampezzo, this fourth Milka live chat with Elena Cortoni. Un grande buongiorno a tutti voi e a te. Was this correct?
Yes, perfect.
Thank you. How are you? Everything fine?
I'm okay. Yes, I'm fine.
We are really glad to have you now for 1 hour. The next 60 minutes are ours and yours, of course. And there's just one rule for today, for the next hour. You can ask whatever you want. You can ask Elena whatever you want. You just have to write us your questions on www.milkashestars.com/livechats. And as you see on our iPads, the questions will arrive soon. But of course, first of all, we talk about the situation here in Cortina at the moment. If you look outside the window, it's snowing. I just arrived 1 hour ago. Since when are you in Cortina d'Ampezzo now?
I'm here since Tuesday. Yeah, okay. I've been training a couple of days and I was waiting to race, but we didn't race actually. So we'll see about tomorrow. And otherwise, we will race next week.
Because the races from Garmisch are will be held here.
Yeah, it's here. All moved here in Italy. That's good in home country.
I think that's good for you. Or so, four races in Italy. What does racing at home in Italy mean for you? Something special?
It's nice. It's always nice to speak our own language when we are on tour. We are always around the world, so it's not so typical to speak Italian with people around the town. So it's fun. It's nice.
So you like it, or some racers may say, okay, racing at home, it's a little bit of more pressure, more interviews to do, more fans, more crowds. How do you handle this?
I like it both. I mean, it's different. It's nice to change, as I said before, and I think, I'm proud to be Italian, and I'm proud if I have Italian fans. But it's also super nice to have strangers as fans, like from all over Europe or all over the world. Mm-hmm. So
there's also another possibility, the guys out there, you don't, there's not just the possibility to ask Elena whatever you want, you also can write us, hey Elena, I want an autograph from you, and there we have the cards, nice picture, where is it from, where was that?
It was in Solden, not my best race, but...
So it in Solden, in Austria?
Yes.
This season? So the first race in the season?
First
the giant
race,
slalom.
Yes.
Okay, good. We have enough of them here. So we will have a look on the first question of today's Milka live chat with Elena Cortoni. It's, what would you say, Katalin Wojciu, the name?
Wojciu.
Wojciu. Hey, Katalin.
Yes.
Katalin, yes. You see the question right here. She wants to know, are you going to Sochi?
I don't know yet, actually, because we have a pretty tough qualifications in our team. We have to be one time in top 6 or twice in top 8. And I didn't do it yet, but I still have some races, some chances to do it, and we'll see.
So your best result this season was
11.
The 11th place?
Yes.
Okay,
in
Super
GS.
G? Or GS?
GS.
Okay,
yeah.
It also was in Austria.
Yes.
I think. In
Lienz. Perfect.
Okay, so my thing is right, but the qualification says either one on the top 6 or twice?
Two, top 8.
Top 8, okay.
It's pretty tough, but I think I can do it if everything goes all right.
I hope so for you. So first question is answered. Katja is next and wants to know. Now the question is away, but Katja, you will write it once again and we will answer, we will post the question to Elena. Alice, first of all, ciao Alice, that's
ciao.
Elena, Alice, and Elena, that's Alice. What do you think just a few seconds before the start of a race? Yes.
Yeah, it's not so much going on in my head. I pretty much think that I'm so lucky and it's a chance that I can take it all in, so I can do my best, I can try to do my best in this 1.5 minute that I have to show, and have fun with it. I think it's the best thing I can do in my life right now, so I try to enjoy it every moment.
Mm-hmm. So the seconds before the start, is there something you do which is which is the same before every race, some kind of routine do you have?
I think every athlete have his own routine, his own doing something.
What's yours?
I always close my buckles, my boots, like many times. I don't know why.
So you close it, open it, close it,
yeah,
open it?
Yeah, I just continue to, I don't know, do stuff with those things.
Okay.
I don't know.
Okay.
And then I pretty much relax, and I always look at my technician in the back.
Yeah.
Before to start, like 10 seconds, and I, hi, then I go.
Okay. What's his name?
Mattia.
Mattia. So maybe we can see him in the next race, when Elena will greet him and say, hey, Mattia, all the best. Okay. Alice, thanks for your question. Next one is from Lisa Maria. She can see us. You won't see her, but she wants to know, Elena, what is the first thing you do when you get up on a competition day?
When
so
I
the
stay
morning,
up.
I guess. Yeah.
I try to open my eyes because it's
okay.
Usually pretty early, and I'm not an early person, so it takes a while to wake up, and then I try to get myself to breakfast.
Okay, so how long does it take you from open your eyes to go in the bathroom?
40 minutes.
Really?
No, after breakfast. Like,
okay.
But right now, like, when I wake up to wash my face and everything, then it's like 10. Yeah, 10 minutes.
Okay, that's quite fast, I think. But the most important question, you like to sleep.
Yes, I do. Yeah, super much.
Okay, so thank you, Lisa Maria, for that question. Kati is the next one. Can I have an autograph for me? So Kati, and for my friend Lena. Thanks, all the best for the next races. Of course, Kati, you can. Elena will do it right away. So one autograph, please, for Kati, and one for Lena. So that's your sign?
Yes.
Really? Okay.
Yes. I don't know. It doesn't.
Okay. We will show them. It's quite interesting. This autograph of Elena Cortoni.
Kathy.
That's for you. And maybe you see it. It's some painting. Some art.
Yeah, I do like to draw, so I try to put something in my sign too.
So that's not just Elena Cortoni, that's...
No, it is, actually.
Kind of. Nobody would have the possibility to copy it. It's your own. That's just Elena Cortoni. And for one for Kati and one for Lena, please. Okay. And we keep in mind, one of your hobbies to draw.
Yes, paint and draw. Mm-hmm.
So there are many, many possibilities to draw and paint. How do you do it? With which colors or how big are the pictures?
I prefer oil colors.
Okay.
At home I have a small, really small place to do my hobby, and it's kind of relaxing me. Every time I do it, I put my mind somewhere else, so I don't have to think about all the routine or if I'm stressed, so I can have a break with my head.
Okay, and then what are you going to do with these paintings? Where are they?
At home.
Really?
Yes.
All of them?
Yeah, I got some. I was selling some, but not so many. I don't have so much time to make them. So when I'm on tour, I pretty much have a small paper like this and some pencils.
You mean I'm here in some seconds?
You mean
paper like that?
Yes, pretty much.
Okay. There is one question from Lucas. Can you draw a Milka cow?
Ooh.
Of course, it's my question. But if somebody tells me he is able to paint, I have to check that.
Okay.
You can draw a Milka cow. We have some guys around here. They will judge that, of course.
Okay.
The whole Milka team is here. So you have now, Elena, 60 seconds to draw a Milka
seconds.
Cow.
Okay.
Yes, here is one.
Okay, perfect. So I can color it.
Yeah.
I can take some.
And in the meanwhile, there's the information for you, Kati. These cards will be right here, and they will come to you in the next days. Of course, the Milka team will send it to you. Okay. So I checked the next question. So painting, was it a hobby from you since you were able to draw, or just in the
Yes,
yeah?
pretty much. I was in the kinder school,
Yeah.
and the teachers told my mom that I was really better than my same age
Yeah.
kids. So they told to my mom to, I don't know, put me in some art school somewhere else.
Okay, so
So when I was 6 years old, I went to this Spanish painter. And I was
okay.
drawing after school, and I was just painting and drawing and doing with my things.
Okay.
Yeah.
So we can be quite happy that you have chosen a career as a skiing world class athlete and not as a drawer and painter. Okay. So yeah, this is a cow. Now everybody is getting really excited to see your cow.
Kind of.
Wow, perfect. Can we have an applause from you guys? So there are one, two, three, four, five guys sitting out there, and from the Milka team.
Wait, I have to write Milka on it.
Yes, of course. And we can do one thing. The first guy that sends us, what should we tell them? Just Forza Italia. The next one who will write Forza Italia will be the owner of this painting and picture. Okay for you?
Perfect.
Perfect. Okay. Next question from I think it's an Italian name, Alice. Is that correct?
Yes,
Alice?
Alice, perfect.
Or if you're from Scotland, Alice. What was your plan B instead of skiing? Did you have one?
Yes, when I was 17, I got graduated at school, at the art school, and
Yeah.
I was choosing between university or skiing. And yeah, my thoughts were skiing is not forever. I cannot ski until 6 years old. I mean, I can do it for fun, but not
Yeah.
racing. So I was, yeah, I can paint when I am done with this career, because I was pretty good at skiing, so I decided
Okay.
to continue with that. And otherwise, I would go to Brera in Milan. It's like a famous art university, and I wanted to study sculpture.
Okay. Next question from Marta. Just imagine if you would be alone on an island, she says. Which which island would it be? Do you have some famous spot in the world where you want to go?
I don't know. I just need white beach and blue sea.
Yeah.
So whatever, and palms.
Okay, and the most important question behind that, which three things are you going to take with you?
Some papers,
Okay.
some pencils,
Okay.
and my boyfriend.
Ah,
So
okay. Perfect.
I'm not so alone.
Good solution. Once again, Lucas, how is the relationship to the other Italian skiers in your team? I think it's good.
We are close to each other. I mean, it's like a second family for us. We are always around, and we have fun. We try to have fun with each other and make jokes sometimes. Of course, like in a normal family.
Is there somebody you would say, okay, that's my best friend or like a sister or
I have my sister in the
of
team,
course.
so I guess she's my best friend and my sister.
Okay, perfect. That would
And
be another question from my side. What does Irene mean to you? I mean, she's a little bit older. How?
she's 6 years older than me.
Okay. So
But we
is
have
it
been together in the team since a lot now.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's nice to have her around.
Okay. So it's not just your team, it's your real family. That's
Yeah.
true. Sina is the next one, and she wants to ask or she wants to know, how do you celebrate your birthday in 2 weeks? I think it's the 3rd of February.
Yes, it is.
You're going to turn 23.
23,
Okay,
yes.
yes, so special year for us. You just will be 23 once in a life. So
Yeah.
what are your plans there?
I hope I will be qualified for Olympics so I can enjoy it even better. As a 23 years old girl, I can go to Olympics. That's not something you can always do.
Yeah.
And I will probably skiing because it's February and it's in the middle of the season, so I think it's a Monday, so we're not racing this year. Too bad. I like to race on my birthday.
Really?
Yes, I do.
Okay.
It's kind of a special day.
So there are no plans, actually?
No.
What you will do there?
No, I'll try to enjoy the day and ski.
Okay, painting or skiing.
Yeah.
That is something we learned from you in the first 15 minutes. Lena asks, are you interested in other winter sports?
Yes. I mean, my boyfriend is kind of putting me into hockey. I don't really know.
Okay, really?
So much about it. But the hockey, I got a hockey t-shirt yesterday night in Cortina.
Really?
So
he plays hockey, or?
Yes, he does. Yeah.
Okay.
He's Swedish, so of course he does.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you ever played together?
No.
Hockey?
No.
You in a goal and?
No. I used to ice skating when I was little, but I'm not so.
Okay.
Hockey player, no. I'm more figure skating.
Tomislav wants to know, who is your favorite skier?
It's always been Didier Kush.
Yeah?
Yes.
Why?
I don't know. I always liked him, and I was always cheering for you last year before World Champs.
Mm-hmm.
I met him at the restaurant before the race, and I was asking for an autograph on my
really?
Helmet.
Yeah.
Too bad my race didn't go as expected, but I had my idol autograph
up
on
there.
My helmet.
Okay, so Didier Kush isn't racing anymore.
No.
Do you have some guy out there, or some kind of idol, or did you have an idol before?
When I was little, I was always stuck with Isolde Kostner.
Yeah.
Yes, I was always copying the way she was skiing, and I remember she was, because I stay in Ledo's Alp in summer, and they were coming there for camps, summer camps,
mm-hmm.
skiing, and I was going in their course, like I was 6-5 years old, and
mm-hmm.
it was always this small kid in their course, and they were complaining about it, and
yeah.
it was me. Yeah.
Okay, and now it's the moment we all were waiting for. The first one writes us Forza Italia. I think it's Michele, or?
Yes.
Is it?
Michele.
So Michele,
yes.
That's for you. Our milk cacao painted by Elena Curtoni herself.
Per Michele.
Per Michele, of course. Yes. Is it the first drawing from you don't keep at home?
No.
Or do you
no.
make some kind of
you know in some
presents?
Restaurants there's this paper on the
yeah,
table
yeah.
and if I have a pen I can stop my hand, I just start to draw, so, and it says there, I don't take it off.
Okay. Cool. You will get it, Michele. We will send it to you, of course. Is it the first cow you ever painted?
No, probably not. I don't know.
You
I
like
was
to draw cows?
No, I prefer to draw people, actually.
Okay. Okay, but it's only one Milka cow, so perfect. Susa, how are you today? Related to the cancellation of the races today. Are you happy with that situation, or?
I'm all fine, so
yeah.
I'm good. But it, of course, it's always a bummer if a race
mm-hmm.
gets cancelled, but what you can do, you cannot really decide the weather, so it's how it is, and it's just to go with
mm-hmm.
it. I went training in another place after they said that it was cancelled, so I had my work, I had my day.
Okay, so what was your day? What did you do today?
I did inspection first, and yeah, it didn't look so good actually. The snow
yeah.
was pretty soft, and but I was really sure they were making it. I
mm-hmm.
got surprised when they
yeah.
were cancelled.
Okay.
But and after it, I did a couple of runs, like warm up, and then I went in the bar where my teammates were.
Yeah.
Then we had the news.
Okay. Lola, who is your best friend in the World Cup who is not a part of the Italian team?
I can meet a lot with Lotte Seyerse, the Norwegian girl,
mm-hmm.
and I have some friends in the American team, as Leanne Smith or Lauren Ross.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, they're kind of arty people too.
Mm-hmm. Elena wants to know from Elena, after your crash in Beaver Creek, everything is fine now?
Yes, it is fine. I still have a pain in my elbow, but it's getting better and better every day.
Okay, so
so
racing as a world-class skier, does it mean to live with problems or
Yeah,
pains?
we are pretty lucky in the team. We have a therapist, so we can join him in the room like for treatments every day, pretty much. But I'm fine these days. It's all good. Then everyone has his own little problems sometimes, like the back or the knees. Who has bigger problems, who has smaller.
Yeah.
I'm pretty lucky, I'm pretty healthy.
Yeah.
It's just this fall that gave me some pains. But
I mean, it's I think it's a special situation you are in. You are, first of all, young. That how many years are you racing now in the World Cup? Three, four?
It's my fourth.
Fourth
year.
Years?
Yes.
You're racing nearly all disciplines.
Yes.
So it's a big, big program for you. Also, big, big amount. For you, how do you handle this?
I don't see it like a heavy program. It's it is heavy sometimes for the body. I get tired in the season, but I like it, and I think I will get bored just to train and train the whole winter. I train the whole summer, so I want to race. So it's good that I have a chance to race pretty much every weekend.
Okay, Michael from Düsseldorf is writing us and is. He's watching us at the moment, so you can greet Michael, of course.
Ciao.
Ciao, simply. Ciao, Michael. Hallo und schöne Grüße nach Deutschland. He wants to know, what do you do to come down again if the race like today is cancelled? So how do you relax? How do you spend your time and put the concentration down again? Are there some
Yeah, I'm not
things?
Really at tension. Like, I don't have so much tension in the start of a race, so I don't really have this pressure on me. It's pretty easy. I try to focus if I have a race day, I try to focus, I don't know, like five numbers before me when I put the skis on. I put them pretty early, so I have my time to focus.
And
then
you
before
need the time for closing, opening,
yes,
closing.
That's that takes a while. And then I get tired.
Okay.
Doing that.
Maybe. Okay. Maybe it's something to change, but it's your routine, yeah?
Yes.
Okay.
So it's not so much to do
calming
down if a race gets cancelled.
Okay. Besides that, at this moment, more than 1,500 people are watching us all around the world. So thanks for that. Thanks a lot. And keep on writing the questions for Elena. We are here until 17:30. So 5 p.m. Of course, there are some questions left from you. We had Michael from Düsseldorf. We switch to Marco. First of all, ciao, Elena.
Ciao, Marco.
Do you have any particular song or music to charge yourself up before a race? And of course, in Bocca al Lupo, Per Cortina e Sochi. Is there some special song or music you like?
I like music in general. I'm pretty eclectic, so I listen a lot of different kind of music. I really like Florence and the Machine.
Okay.
And Dog Days Are Over, that's my favorite song.
Mm-hmm.
So I try to listen that before racing.
Okay. Somebody told me that every Italian likes the Italian anthem. Is that true?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah.
You know the text?
Not really.
Well, if somebody here, it's Chiara from the Milka team, and she told me you like to sing, and we can come to me.
Ciao a tutti, sono Chiara, Milka team.
You're also from Italy.
Certo, Milano nazionale. Uno, due, tre.
Fratelli d'Italia,
Italia,
municipio, senti la testa, dove la vittoria se borga
la
schiava di Roma, il Dio la creo.
Finito! There is a new figure here, just five people are watching us. No, this was a joke, that was perfect. That's my applause for you, guys. That was great. Thank you, Chiara. Perfect. It's the anthem which was played after Ferrari is winning. That's the reason why everybody around the world knows the melody.
It's a nice song, I think.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's even nicer if you sing it on a podium.
I hope for you that will be in the next races. So what do you think? When you think about the next races, where would you say, okay, there my chances are bigger compared to another place? Because you like it there or anyhow?
Yeah, of course, there's some slopes I prefer. I liked Garmisch, but too bad it got cancelled, but I like it here too.
Yeah.
I think every race gives you new opportunities and new chances to do your best, so I always try to do my best.
So Garmisch, would you say Garmisch is your favorite track
all
around the world?
I think so. I don't know if it's about my results I had there, because I had my best one, so probably it's because of that. If I will have my best results here, it will be here.
I think the world championships in Garmisch weren't too bad. Sixth place in Super
Yes,
G.
Yes.
2 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so that was your best result in world championships, or
in world champs? Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Next question. Leon asks, "How do you feel for the Olympics? All the best from Croatia." Leon, all the best from Cortina. Back to you. And how do you feel for the Olympics, or? Maybe one question before that, what do the Olympic Games mean to you?
I think Olympics are a big goal for every athlete in every sport, and of course to win it will be a dream come true, but already to go there and see how it is, and it's kind of a party, it's a happy thing in the sport, as the other races, but that's more special for everyone else, and I think I will try to enjoy it if I will go. I will be pretty excited.
So Sochi will be the first Olympics for you, of course. Okay. Klaus is the next one. What is your wish for your birthday besides Sochi?
I think I was a good girl, so I deserve a nice bag, nice shoes.
Okay, maybe your friend is watching, your boyfriend is watching at the moment, so that's the chance for you to fulfill Elena's wishes. What if your boyfriend would be watching us at the moment? What would be a perfect present?
No, I cannot be so material. I would be
you
more...
You can.
I like bags.
Just be honest. Okay. Big bags, small bags.
Every kind.
Which color? Doesn't matter.
No.
Okay, so if you want a present for Elena, just bags. Okay, Anna wants to know, where do you get inspiration for your style? For example, clothes,
Yeah,
hair.
I follow some blogs, some...
Really?
And I really like clothes, so I always go on sites to watch some clothes to get some tips. Yeah.
I think Anna wants to know which blogs.
Yeah, random ones. I don't really remember. I don't have like particular ones.
Yeah.
I always change. And I always read Vogue or some magazines, like fashion magazines.
Yeah.
I'm really into it.
So you're a normal girl?
Yes, typical one.
Okay. Bianca wants to know, what was the most beautiful moment in your career?
I don't know. I think every good memory stays in the mind, and I have a lot of them since I started skiing, since I was little, so I cannot really choose one. Of course, being six in the World Champs, my first World Champs, my first world like year in the World Cup, it was a big thing for me.
What's the reason for the talent team being so good this season? Why is the talent team so strong, powerful this season?
I think we all girls tried to take us a little bit upper from last season, because it was like not good, not bad. It was kind of middle way season. So everybody wants a bit more. And I think this qualification for Sochi is putting us some more pressure, and everybody wants to show and to do the best to go there, of course.
Now, you guys, you see already the question from Selena. Can you imagine to live outside of Italy or Europe? Any place where you would like to go or to move?
Yes, I think so. Next to a sea. I like warm.
Okay.
Yes.
So,
Even if I'm a
a
skier,
sea outside of Italy or no coasts in Italy?
I mean, Italy is pretty good place to be. I like Tuscany a lot and I like all the coasts. So I don't cannot really choose. I like Spain.
Okay.
Yeah, that I like. I like
So any
Minorca.
favorite place you already have been to?
Yeah, Minorca I've been and I
Yeah.
really like that.
Okay. So you also could imagine to live there?
I think so. Cannot
Yeah.
be so tough, yes.
I don't know where the next question comes from. It sounds Japanese. Suki. What would you say, Elena? Is it from Japan or is it a typically Italian name?
No, it doesn't look Italian.
Okay, Suki, wherever you are, nice evening and welcome from Cortina. Do you have, Elena, a favorite painting or favorite museum?
I've been to Amsterdam, the Van Gogh Museum, and that was really, really good. I really like Schiele as a painter. It's not super famous one. It's
Chile.
pretty famous, but
Maybe not
not
in
like
Japan,
Van Gogh
but
or
yes.
yes. Yeah, I like him. And I like Modigliani also. Modigliani, it's an Italian painter. He used to paint this girl woman with long neck.
Modigliani. Modigliani. Suki, did
Modigliani.
you hear this? Modigliani. Just write down and Google it, of course. I don't know him, I'm very sorry, but I know another famous painter. From now on, it's Elena Cortoni. You know this
Yeah.
picture? It's from her. Thank you, Tuki, for your question. Let's move on to Stefan Bosak. Have you ever visited New York? And did you know you have fans in New York?
Nice. I've never been there. It would be great to go there.
New York City, yes.
Yes. Cool.
Okay, so it's just Stefan and 1,500 other people watching us now. You can talk to Stefan Bosak. I think he's in New York at the moment. 10 seconds for you.
Hi, can I come there?
Okay, perfect. Perfect use for 10 seconds. Okay, Stefan, that was your question, so please write us your answer in the next 30 minutes. Clementine, I think. Hi. Hi. How do you feel just before the race when you are in the start gate? I think you already mentioned there is not really tension, it's you're really relaxed.
Yes, I am.
Yeah.
But I'm always been also when I was a kid. I remember my dad was my coach and he was
Yeah.
in the start. I don't want anybody in the start gate. I want to be alone because it's my place, it's my bubble. So, and I was always pushing my dad outside of that. So now it became my place.
Martin wants to know how important is skiing in Italy? He sends us greetings from Berlin, Germany.
I
Schönen
think
guten Abend nach Berlin.
it's a big sport. I mean, it's not big as football, soccer, of
Yeah.
course. But I think there's, especially in the north, it's pretty famous. Everybody likes to ski, and we have beautiful mountains. Like here in Cortina, it's amazing. Dolomiti are the best ones, I think.
Yeah. Your hometown, or you were born in Morbegno,
Yes.
so it's in the northern part of Italy. Are there any mountains like here in Cortina?
Yes, Pescegallo.
Bescegallo.
Pescegallo.
Besce come fish, come
Yes,
fish.
yes.
Bescegallo.
And yep,
Okay.
but it's a really small place. It's where I started to ski. It's two lifts, one
Okay.
chairlift and one ski
Yeah.
lift, and the slope is pretty flat.
Okay. So, Morbegno was your birthplace. Where do you live exactly now?
Cosio, Valtellina. It's right next to there.
Okay.
Yes.
Susanna, how important is nutrition for you as a skier?
I think skiers doesn't really need a diet,
Yeah.
so we don't have to be super skinny or super different.
Yeah.
I like to eat everything. I try to change a lot, like carbs in the lunch and meat in the night, like normal stuff.
So what's your favorite meal or what do you like to eat?
Pizza.
Really?
Yes.
Okay, perfect. We keep that in mind because we will talk about pizza in some seconds.
Okay.
I don't tell you any more details now because there is one important question. Before that, Yara wants to know, have you ever thought about modeling because you are that beautiful?
Oh, thank you. If I look at Vogue, then I like that. I don't know if I could be able to do it. It would be fun to try, though.
Yeah?
Yes.
So you, if you have the possibility, you want to try it?
Yeah, why not?
Yeah?
Yes.
Okay, and now Chiara's question. Are you allowed to eat pizza?
Yes.
Yes?
Yes.
What's your favorite pizza?
Every kind of it.
Really?
I always change. I never take the same one.
Okay.
Yes.
So if now waiter comes in and say, okay, which pizza do you like?
It will take 15 minutes with the list before to choose it, but then...
So not just
now,
margarita?
No, of course not. I think now I will choose something with small tomatoes, rucola, some parmigiano. Yes.
Okay. Chiara writes us from Bologna.
Good.
Good, it's okay for you. Okay, then that's okay for me. Of course, it's okay. We had Germany, we had Slovenia, we had New York, we
yeah.
had Italy, Bologna, we
Suki.
Had Suki from Japan, of course. So it's really an honor for us. And I have one detail more. Now they are 2,000 people who are watching us at the moment.
That's a lot. Perfect.
That's really a lot. While we are sitting in snowy Cortina, it's
yeah.
snowing at the moment outside.
Never
beautiful
stops.
Winter wonderland. Like nowhere else in Europe, I guess. Okay, so Kati wants to know something about Cortina. What is so special here in Cortina?
I think the landscape is the most special things. Mountains are really nice. Tofana and everything else, it's amazing. And... shopping
mm-hmm.
window.
Really? Are there possibilities to shop in Cortina?
Yes, there's some nice shops.
Yeah?
Yes.
So, in the last days, you already had been shopping? Honestly?
Yes.
Really?
I did.
Yeah?
Actually.
Okay.
But I saw a pair of boots and I will try them just if I deserve it in the racing.
Okay, so you already bought something or?
A belt.
A belt?
Yes. Yes. Okay.
Is this one?
Yes.
Can we show the belt? Okay, so it's new.
Yes.
It's from Cortina. Perfect. Okay.
Souvenir.
Of course. We have Kati, we already had. Then Michael from Düsseldorf, question concerning the powerful Italian team. It's the same question, so thanks, Michael. Corrado from Cagliari. That's your question in Italian. My Italian is really bad, but I just tried.
Oh, that's a good question.
Allenarti in Sardegna. Okay, just translate it once into English.
He's wondering when I go train in Sardegna.
He's wondering about?
Yes. Whenever
okay.
you want.
Okay. So he asks you when you
yes,
will come to Sardegna
to
train there.
If I will ever go train in Sardegna, yes. Every time.
So, Corrado, every time, anytime you invite Elena, I think. Now it's not Corrado, it's Vienna, Austria calling. Did you know Milka before you come a testimonial? All the best.
Yes.
Yeah?
Yes. Milka has always been like this violet helmets. I always saw them
mm-hmm.
in World Cup racing. When I was little, I was watching on TV. It's always been someone.
Okay.
So
I think as a testimonial, you also get some chocolate. What's your favorite chocolate from Milka?
I like the white one, simple white one.
Let me see. Alpenmilch. It's
I
no.
I should bring mine.
Do we have white chocolate here, guys from Milka? Where is the white chocolate for Elena? Okay, we have 20 minutes left. Yes, it's that. Oh no, it's also strawberry chocolate. Okay, but the Milka guys told me you ate everything of the white chocolate, so no more white chocolate in whole Milka land at the moment. We have now Bara from Czech Republic. How often do you eat Milka chocolates?
I had a piece of it just before coming here.
Really?
Yes.
Okay. Do you want?
We no, I just had it.
Okay. So yeah. It's just me. Okay. Roberto, where have you learned skiing? Was it together with Irene? In Pescegallo?
In Pescegallo, yes.
Okay.
In this small place. But it was not with my sister because she is older than me, so she learned before me.
Mm-hmm.
And I was 2 years when I put my skis, my first skis on. They were plastic skis with boots and I didn't like it, so my dad was like, okay, she doesn't like it, she will do something else.
Mm-hmm.
But after a couple of months, he was putting real skis on and I never took them off.
Okay, Elena, what's your favorite city in Italy? Clara wants to know.
I'm close to Milan, I often go there and I like it. But I think Rome is one of the best.
Mm-hmm. Why?
It has its
own
charm.
You have 1 minute, I have to enjoy my chocolate now. So what's so special on
it has a charm.
Which one?
I don't know, this light is... It's nice, I've been once. Yes, it's kind of, I don't know, something special feeling. Cannot really explain, is it good?
You have to explain, I'm not finished. And it's very unpolite to speak with something in your mouth directly to 2,000 people.
But you're speaking to me, you know, so
that's true, so it's no problem for you.
No, it's okay.
Okay.
I can do it.
So, next question from Sven. Hey Elena, how do you overcome your fear to get every time faster on a downhill course?
It's pretty natural for us. I think I'm not so scared about speed or jumps or something else, but in ski racing, every turn is kind of going against yourself because
mm-hmm.
your instinct tells you to do something, but you don't have to do that because otherwise it's slow. So that's the adrenaline part. That's the most fun thing.
Mm-hmm.
If you can do it, then when you can do it, then it's more fun.
Mm-hmm. Maybe you know there is a project going on milkaskistars.com/games of tenderness, where you can send your energy to Elena. It's a game which you can play. You know that, of course. So just click on milkaskistars.com/games of tenderness and send Elena your energy during or for the next races. There are 4 races up or still to come here in Cortina. So if I am informed right, there is the plan. There should be 2 Super Gs and 2 downhill.
Yes. Yeah, one night is supposed to be tomorrow.
Yeah.
But we'll see. Otherwise...
I don't think so because
yeah.
It's snowing a lot.
It's snowing a lot.
So it
yes.
will be tough next week, or if there are 4 races, each day you race.
Yes, I'm used to. So it's good.
Of
I
course.
I also wanted to go race at Europe Cup on Monday, so...
Okay. Yara, we already had her question concerning modeling.
Yes.
And you are beautiful, beautiful. Okay. Mari, very important question. I think many young guys are watching us at the moment and maybe they want to become a professional skier too. What's your advice if young boys, young girls are watching us and they want to become a professional skier? Is that something important you can tell them?
I think you have to train, of course, but you really have to enjoy it. It's really fun and for me it's my passion, so it comes easy,
mm-hmm.
but it's fun, it's the most fun thing, and you need to work every day a little bit more, and I think it comes.
Mm-hmm. I mean, that sounds very easy. You have to enjoy and you have to like it, but I guess there are some situations where you are not happy. If you're not satisfied with the result of a race, how do you overcome that?
I try to think positive, of course. In everything in the life, I think it's some moments that are not the best ones.
Mm-hmm.
If you go in the office every day, I think it's not super fun.
Mm-hmm.
My office is outside, it's in the mountains, in the snow, so I'm lucky with that.
Mm-hmm.
And if a race goes wrong, then I try to think to turn the page and think the next one.
Mm-hmm.
I always have a lot of opportunities.
Mm-hmm. Which of the other Milka stars do you understand best and why? A guy called Vienna Calling wants to know.
I'm really friend with Tessa. It's too bad she got injured and I wish her a good healing.
Mm-hmm.
I think I come together with her because we are not so far with age and I've
mm-hmm.
seen her since I was younger.
Mm-hmm. So the reigning GS world champion Tessa Wally.
Yeah.
Maybe she is watching us at the moment.
Hopefully.
At the moment. So all the best for your injury and rehabilitation. Mattia, that guy sounds Italian. Do you have any lucky objects or special rituals, routines?
Yeah, routines in the start.
Yeah.
That's the only one.
Don't.
So something I don't have it here. I got a necklace.
Okay.
It's a pepper. I got it from my
pepper.
Yes.
Okay.
I got it from my first coach. I just got it. So
okay.
I'm wearing it every race.
And
hoping for some good luck.
And maybe the most actual lucky object you are wearing, your belt. Hey,
yes.
Don't forget about that. Okay, so Matthias, thanks for your questions. If you like to have autographs from Elena, you also can order that in the next 20 minutes here on the Milka Live Chat, live broadcasted from Cortina. Tomislav Bekas, can I have an autograph for me? Thanks, you are the best, Elena. Tomislav Bekas, which country do you guess is he from? Czech Republic?
Yeah, somewhere from the east, probably.
Okay. Tomislav Bekas. Yes, that's right. So, Tomislav, we are just collecting the autographs and then it will be sent to you from the Milka team, of course. Thanks for that. Is it your dream to become a painter after your career? Tina wants to know.
Yes, can be a dream. It's my other passion, so it's at the same level as skiing. So it would be great if that can
mm-hmm.
be my second job.
Mm-hmm.
But we'll see how the life goes. It will always be part of me, so we'll see.
Mm-hmm. Very interesting and nice question from Natine. Elena, you usually take part in the speed races, while Irene skis more in the technical disciplines. Have you always been the wilder sister?
No, she used to race speed too,
mm-hmm.
but she was quitting pretty early. She was not so good.
Okay, so what are the differences between you and Irene?
We have different personalities. She's really strong in the head. She's more like the math one,
mm-hmm.
and I'm more the arts one.
Okay.
So that's, I think that can explain.
Mm-hmm. Okay, besides skiing, nice question from Marchetta. What was the last movie you saw?
I've seen yesterday an Italian movie.
Okay.
Benvenuti a Sud. It was on TV.
Okay.
It's a pretty funny one.
Okay. So which kind of movies do you like? Comedy or
comedies are always pretty nice
yeah.
to see. It's easy to see them. It's fun. I like movies when in costume. Like I was watching Anna Karenina lately.
Okay.
In English. It was pretty tough to understand for me, but
yeah.
I got it.
Mm-hmm. So any favorite movie for you?
Il favoloso mondo di Amélie.
Ah, okay. I don't know the
it's a French
English
movie, yeah.
Yeah.
I don't
die
know
Fabel
the title in
Amelie
English.
In German.
Mm-hmm.
But I think everybody knows it, of course. Marco da
Lecco.
Lecco,
yes.
Sì, vero. Do you have any other sport you like to follow and watch on TV besides alpine skiing?
Lecco is not so far from my hometown.
Ah, okay.
Mm-hmm.
Perfect, so maybe you know him. Maybe your former boyfriend?
No.
No? Okay, so there was no Marco.
No.
Never been a Marco, okay. Sorry for you, Marco. But a big, big fan of you, so are there any other sports you like to watch?
I was watching ice skating yesterday night. It was our Italian team racing there. It was European.
So you spent the whole last evening in front of the TV?
Yes, pretty much.
Yeah.
Almost.
Okay. So ice skating? Every Italian likes to watch soccer, play soccer?
Not really a big fan of it. I mean, I watch it when my dad is occupying the old couch.
Yeah.
And he's watching a game, so I have to
you
watch
have
it
to.
Pretty much.
Okay,
yeah.
So any favorite team?
No.
Really?
Yes.
No, no.
My dad is a Juventus
okay.
fan.
So you have to be a Juventus fan.
Yes.
Yeah. More or less.
Yes.
Mario and Susie are watching us at the moment and want to know, have you ever tried to ski in the water?
No, that's something I would like to try.
Yeah?
Yes.
Okay, so simple answer, no, but still to come. Liliana. If you can decide, would you like to live in the mountains or at the sea?
I could choose both, like for summer in the sea, winter in the mountain, that would be perfect.
Okay, and what's your favorite ski resort? I think we already talked about that.
Le Travalet in France.
Okay.
That's good.
Yeah.
But for racing, Garmisch is one
yeah.
of my favorites.
And why this one in French? What is so special
it's
there?
It's so big, you can ski everywhere pretty much. It's one of the biggest in Europe, so it's amazing.
Mm-hmm. Sophia is there and she's watching us also right at the moment and wants to know who is your roommate?
Right now?
Yes.
Typical.
Typically and now.
When I'm with the tech team, it's my sister.
Okay.
When I'm the speed team, it's right now is Francesca Marsaglia,
mm-hmm.
but I started the year with Sofia Goggia, but she got injured. Yeah, that's sad, but yes,
okay.
It's fun to have roommates, not to be alone all the time.
Maybe you know this situation. So double bedroom,
mm-hmm.
one bed near to the window and one bed near to the door. Which one is yours?
I always change.
Really?
Yes, I do.
So it's
last
hard for
I
Francesca.
Last time I was next to the window and this time I'm next to the door.
So no favorite place?
No.
Okay. Maria, do you speak other languages than Italian and English? For instance, German or French?
Yeah, I do speak French.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm not so good at it. I can understand pretty good. But
okay.
To talk is a bit tougher because I never studied.
Yeah.
I should put myself on a book and try to.
Okay, so
yes.
So one sentence should be possible, or?
Yes, of
for
course.
Maria,
I can survive.
De la France.
De la France.
Si?
Bonsoir, Maria,
oui.
Ça va?
Ah, parfait. Something else you want to tell her?
Je suis Elena, je suis Italien.
Okay, perfetto. Jacqueline Stroh. Or Jacqueline Stroh. Can I have an autograph for me and my brother, Christopher? Thanks, Elena.
You're welcome.
Yes, of course. So, one for... I think it's Jacqueline.
Jacqueline?
Jacqueline. Jacqueline Stroh. And then, in the meanwhile, I'm searching for the most... intimidate question. Let me see. Ah, I have one. We have some minutes left, of course, so your last questions, please write it now. And of course, you can ask for an autograph, or of course, you can send your energy to Elena on milkaskistars.com/games of tenderness. And Jacqueline and Christopher. These are yours. Okay, so many autographs collected, but some of them still to come. Richie wants to know, how important are the team rules? Are there any team rules?
I don't know. I think it's kind of, you have to be educated as usual with everyone else. I think so.
Okay, so there is
we
no
don't
rule
have really special
which says...
rules. I mean, yes,
o'clock.
You don't have to be late, of course.
Really?
Because otherwise you don't go where you have to go. They just leave you with the hotel. If you have to go skiing and you are 2 minutes late, then the van is gone.
Okay, but is there is nobody who says, okay, it's 9 o'clock in the night, you have to go
no,
to bed now?
No, we are pretty grown up, so I think we can handle it by ourselves.
Okay. Laura wants to know, or says, ciao Elena, sei ancora insieme a Mats?
Yes,
I am.
I
know you are.
Yes, I am.
He is the hockey player and skier,
yeah.
Of course. Siete bellissimi entrambi. That's correct?
Yes.
Okay, buona fortuna per le prossime gare.
Grazie.
Okay, Angela, do you like to cook? She wants to know.
I do, but I'm not so good at it. I think I still have to learn better.
Okay, so if another... another situation, of course, just in our minds.
Mm-hmm.
Mats comes to you and says, oh, Elena, I'm that hungry. Please cook something for me. What can you cook for him?
Pasta.
Okay. Solo pasta, just...
Yeah, I think that's my best one.
Okay.
It's not so tough to make with...
Okay, just noodles or...
No,
with
something else, some kind of sauces or something. Of course, I always change. I always use what's in fridge.
What's there?
Yes.
Okay. What's your favorite food, Italian food? I think it's...
pizza.
Pizza?
Yes.
Okay. And besides pizza, if there is no pizza to find, what do you have to
eat? I can eat everything else.
Really?
Yes.
Okay, we are online or... Yes, we are. Thank you for the information, István, that we are online again. So, guys, you may have recognized we have been away. We went for a little walk outside the beautiful snow of Cortina, of course. And maybe also this was the reason for the last minutes and the... broke up of the connection here from Cortina d'Ampezzo, but we already, Elena, are talking for 1 hour. There have been a lot of questions, many private, many interesting questions. I already got, I also got the information that Irene was watching us at the moment. So Irene, ciao, nice to have you there. Where is Irene at the moment?
At home, at her home.
In
Rovereto.
Rovereto, okay.
Yes.
So nice that you are with us at the moment too. One final question. I mean, you're quite young at the moment, 22, next month 23. So many years of world-class racing ahead of you. But someday, if you talk about after your career as a professional skier, what are your plans?
You never know about it. I mean, art is one of my plans, but you never know how it is, how it's going to be, what I will do in my career. Then it depends. Maybe I can find a place in the ski world or somewhere else. I don't know. I have no idea.
It's quite a lot of time to come and to this situation. So, okay, I think we enjoyed... hour, 60 minutes here in Cortina with Elena Cotoni, with interesting questions, nice questions from all over the world. As you remember, New York, Japan, Germany, Austria, Italy, of course, Slovenia, Czech Republic. So we are looking forward to the next Milka live chats. It will be with Maria Höfel-Riesch. You will see the dates on milkaskistars.com. We are looking forward to that. And the last thing, of course, we all here, the Milka team in Cortina, and the more than 2,000 people who have been watching us, we are crossing the fingers for you in our next races here in Cortina. All the best. And now, Elena, yeah, a nice evening. Enjoy your pizza with
everything.
Okay, perfect. Bye-bye and nice greetings from Cortina.
Thank you.